It's Thursday, December 23rd, coming up live on The View. They're the hot topics everyone's talking about, from the shocking, smooshing, grenade-launching preview of Jersey Shore Season 3 to the NFL coach whose foot fetish was exposed online. And yesterday's hot topics had some people outraged. So today, the co-hosts are talking back. Plus, if you think things got wild on the air this year, you won't believe what was happening behind the scenes when we unveil YouTube's most unforgettable moments of 2010.
I had no idea.
Then, Emmy winner Jane Lynch is telling you which celebrities are lining up to become Gleeks, what Madonna thought of her voguing, and life as a gay mom in Hollywood. And Miley's sidekick Emily Osment's taking center stage when she performs her brand new hit and exposing what's next now that Hannah Montana's secret identity's been exposed. All that, hot topics, and more coming up live on The View.
These jerseys because ABC is continuing a holiday tradition with their NBA Christmas special, a five-game lineup across ESPN and ABC, and this year's big matchup is the Los Angeles Lakers and the Miami Heat, which you can see at 5 p.m. Eastern on ABC. It's going to be an amazing game. Me, I'm wearing the Knicks because those bad boys won last night, and it was beautiful.
Jersey,
yeah,
just to make trouble. That's where I am, because I think we made a great business decision.
Make it my team in Cleveland. Y'all, sit your behinds down now.
Well, I'm sort of wearing LeBron because I don't want to offend Cleveland because they're so touchy about this.
But now you're afraid of offending.
Truthfully, I thought these were hockey games, but what do I know?
A good hockey puck joke.
It's going to be a fun game.
All right.
Christmas Day, right?
Really?
It's
really?
Christmas
really? Oh, my gosh.
They were trying to make fun of me before, and because I was asking, who... What teams? I don't know anything.
So I told it was a hockey player, a female hockey player.
Nothing.
It's all right.
Well, here's something we do know. Sherry was making sure that Jeffrey is in the spirit this Christmas. She's so genteel and so sweet about it. Tell us about it,
baby. I wanted to make sure he was in the Christmas spirit. I stayed up to about 2 this morning wrapping the presents for his teachers and getting everybody in his life a little present. And I wrote the cards with my left hand with crayons so it could look like, you know, it's from Jeffrey.
Yeah, you do know now that everybody's going to know it's from you.
And everything was all perfect, and I got a Santa suit for Jeffrey with the beard. Aww. And then this morning, I didn't get any sleep, so this morning, he wants to have a tantrum. He didn't want to put the Santa suit on. I was like, look, you're going to put the Santa suit on. You're going to go in there and give him these presents, say, Merry Christmas, God bless you. You're going to smile when you do it.
You
we're good.
You can take the girl out of Jehovah. Cannot take the Jehovah out of the girl is all I have to say. You well, knock on their doors.
You know, yesterday, Sherry was saying that she sends cards with religious pictures to everybody, whether they're Christian or not. Right. Mm-hmm. So some people that stopped me on the street said, tell Sherry that is not correct.
Okay,
so I'm just telling.
They're saying I should.
But the person doesn't believe what you believe. You're wishing them a Merry Christmas or a Happy Hanukkah for their religion.
Would it be the equivalent
it's
of
like
sending
a picture of Barack Obama to Newt Gingrich?
I would love to do that. But that's the thing. Because my... I actually think that would be a good idea.
You can take that position, too.
Or sending someone a card on your birthday, kind of, right?
Like, yes, happy sending yourself a card.
Okay. No taking. I got you.
Well,
I got
perhaps
you.
Perhaps a card would have been in order for Jets coach Rex Ryan. Because he's been deflecting a lot of questions over leaked videos of someone who sounds like Ryan talking about his foot fetish while filming somebody who looks like his old lady, Michelle. You know, you take a look. You see what you think.
Oh, God. Can I help you with anything?
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I was just resting for a few minutes.
Oh, okay. There's no car trouble or anything?
No, none at all. I'm sorry.
Okay. Oh, you don't have to put your feet in. You can leave them out.
Oh, are you sure?
Yeah, oh, yeah. In fact, you have really beautiful feet. Do you mind if I touch them?
I take very good care of
Yes, you do. I can touch them.
Yes.
Thank you.
What do you think?
Oh, wow, they're like really soft.
You have beautiful feet. Can I touch them?
All I have to say is this. I'll take a foot fetish with a man and his wife over a foot fetish with a man and his mistress any day. I don't care what they do. You go with them with your marriage and have a good time.
God bless them. I will match his wife toe for toe, okay? Because I have the best feet.
You know, this is, what's so interesting is this is a married couple. They did this in the privacy of their own home.
Yeah.
It somehow got on the internet.
Somehow, magically. How did it get on the internet?
Well, I don't know. Allegedly, it was on a foot fetish website. Mm-hmm. But then it got on YouTube. I don't know how it got on the internet, but I'm going, you're married. You can do whatever you want in the privacy of your own home. It is none of my business.
Is anyone here on that website? No.
Oh, yeah, like you're supposed to say.
A foot fetish has become, like a football player, I get it. But a shoe salesman would be the proper place to be working, don't you think?
Well, but they did, this was a whole storyline going on. This was a whole foot fetish storyline going on, like the waka 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 thing.
What was that?
The waka waka, you know how the porno feels. Waka waka waka.
Okay. I don't know. I've never heard that song.
On a porn film, they make that
song. It's like the beat.
Okay, this is too much. We're moving on. It's too much. You know, so you make your own decision. Is it your business? Do you care? Hey, it's Christmas time coming. You don't really care.
Exactly.
Rex, do what you do, child. Stay with your wife. God bless you behind.
That's right.
Now, yesterday, we talked in Hot Topics about a nun who was excommunicated for allowing doctors to perform an abortion to save the mother's life. And the reaction we got from some people is kind of something we feel we should be addressing. You know, we got a lot of emails that started, we don't watch your show.
But
if you're going to email us about something that you don't like on the show, perhaps you should watch it.
What?
So you can get the entire story and you can get what we said as opposed to listening to somebody else who just told you to write a letter or a clip.
You know? And, you know, I a gentleman called William Donahoe, who is a interesting fellow. I have nothing ugly to say about him, but I will say that he wrote something about what we talked about yesterday and sort of got it all wrong. You know, we were talking about the fact that it bothered us that someone would excommunicate this nun for saving the life
of the mother,
of the mother who also has four children who would be without her. We thought it was kind of rough.
Yeah.
And not right. And we also said that we thought, how odd, they allowed the pedophile priest to be moved around.
And they never
excommunicated them.
Right.
That was our other point. Well, this gentleman decided that we were crazy and that we were not Catholics.
I have something to say about it.
I think we all do. I know it's going to scare you, Bill. But, yes, I was a Catholic. I went to Catholic school, St. Columba, and I'm proud of it because I learned that God said, only I can forgive you. No one else can forgive you. If you have a problem, come to me because I'm God, and I'm the only one who's got your back. Okay? And he also said, little Jesus, when he was walking around, he saw Mary Magdalene and said, let he who is without sin cast the first stone. And I say that to you, Mr. Donahoe, because you felt it necessary to let people know that I had abortions and to give them the website to go to. Well, guess what? God and I worked it out, baby. And when I stand before him,
that's right.
I don't have anything to worry about. Can you say the same?
I don't think so. This guy, now that you mentioned his name, we have to say it. Mm-hmm. But he is constantly, I understand he's being paid by the Catholic Diocese or somebody is paying him to put the word out to all these people that we are bad. And not just us, other people, whoever criticizes the church in any way, he sends this missive out and then they get on everybody. Mm-hmm. And I also resent the fact that he says that I'm not Catholic. I was baptized a Catholic. Mm-hmm. My daughter was baptized a Catholic. I was married in a Catholic church. When I won $250,000 on the Millionaire Celebrity Show. I gave the $250,000 to the church so that they could buy computers for the Catholic school. I kind of resent it. So in other words, if you have doubt, that makes you anti-Catholic?
Right, and don't tell us we've turned our back on the Catholic Church.
If you criticize the dogma a little bit, or you say maybe this institution is not perfect, they want to excommunicate you. I have never been excommunicated, you know? No. So I am still a Catholic, Belle. And I wish you would just stop saying things like that and making people angry.
And
with
I think
us.
If people get mad.
And Merry Christmas, by the way.
Merry Christmas. But I think if people get angry with us because we get on men who've not been brought to task for attacking innocent children, then you stay mad. Because that's what they attacked innocent children.
Yeah, I just think it's unfortunate, too. And it really, it sort of cuts his point off at the knees when he uses vindictive words, hateful thoughts, and a pointed letter to try to condemn someone else for not being Catholic enough.
I think it's none of our business. It's dangerous to have people turning on us for no good reason. It's not fair.
Well, you know and what?
This is one little man. One little man wrote this letter, and he can just go
it's,
to.
It's okay.
What
you know
do,
what?
Mr.
It's
Donahoe.
It's okay because. You know, we have the right, and it's people like you, William Donahoe, that keep people like us away from the church. We'll be right back with more Hot Topics. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. I don't know what to say. Saying the new season of Jersey Shore is going to make the previous two seasons look like Sesame Street. So, just in time for the holidays, here's a peek at the season 3 of Jersey Shore. Take a look.
I brought a new friend named Tina.
She's 4 feet tall, short little meatball, exactly like Sesame.
Really?
She's totally getting butt naked.
It took a day for somebody to see my goodness.
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to you.
Diana, Tina, whatever the f*** name is.
First of all, and second of all,
you
are a f***ing
slutty ass bitch.
I found you, bitch.
Bitch,
step out of it.
Put your hands on me, Kenny.
The dynamic definitely has changed. It's not one big happy family anymore.
Wow.
Famous, which they are. You know, they're turning on each other. You know, it's interesting to see. And also, they have to up the ante this season. You got
to
get naked now because, so it's only one more season.
I'm going to end up in jail.
No, I predict a sex tape is going to come out on
somebody.
It is. We've
just seen it.
And if somebody going to get it.
It's there.
Oh my God.
Now that's funny. That's funny. Him getting on the pole and falling down. I would watch that.
And you know what's so funny is I wonder how this is going to do. Are people going to support this, just watching this every single day?
Well, there's new members, and mercifully, they're not Italian. I'm so glad. You know, they're from other places now.
Chile and other places.
They've opened up. They've diversified now.
Because, you know, a lot of the Italian-American organizations have been on their case, you know? It's like, it's not a good thing to show people.
So this is not indicative of Italian.
It's not black folks, okay? I'm just really glad. It's not us.
They try to. It don't stay in the air very long.
Can you imagine what would be happening? People would be losing their minds.
Well, you see, that's interesting because the Italians are still butts of humor in this way. And it's not really, it's not for long, though, I have a feeling. It's not right. It's all very wrong.
When she says it's not right, it's not right. Now, I want a word from our sponsor.
Okay, that's me. Okay, the holidays are just a few days away, and with all the hustle and bustle of trying to get gifts wrapped and meals cooked and what have you, it seems impossible to be in touch with all your loved ones. But with Yahoo Mail for mobile, it's now faster and easier to stay connected on the go. For example, my cousin Nunzio gets very emotional this time of year, so to deal with his anxiety, he makes holiday pepperoni wreaths, and he emails them to my mobile phone. I can't even show you his cannoli Christmas tree. This is a family show. And then there's my old friend Immaculata. She recently emailed me that she lost 250 pounds. I said, you're gonna look too thin. When I asked her how, she told me she divorced her husband. I think she's taking being single quite well, yes. Don't you think? So, yes. When you're out and about with your family to-do list, it's easier than ever to get your Yahoo Mail on any phone that gets the internet. I've got Cousin Nunzio's pepperoni wreath with me wherever I go with Yahoo Mail. You can stay connected with those who matter the most. And so that you can capture your own holiday memories and share them just as easily with your favorite people, including Bill Donahue, Yahoo is giving members of our studio audience a Polaroid 12 Mexipixel digital camera. Merry Christmas!
Yeah. Merry Christmas! Hey, we will be right back with the View 2's best behind-the-scenes moments of 2010.
We showed you our best moments that happened out here this year. But there's a whole other show happening back there, backstage, every day. So here are the greatest ViewTube moments from 2010. Watch them.
They say nowadays that the woman should make the first move and not let a guy run after her. So I was gonna send you a drink, but we don't drink here at The View.
So what am I getting instead?
I don't know. I could offer you our producer as a gift.
Bloody hell, this is fantastic.
Yeah, this is what we do at The View. We offer
just been a couple of minutes and I'm getting offered humans.
Yeah. Have you ever thought about an older woman?
I have.
And what are your thoughts?
What do you want me to think?
I'm a little floored right now. Usually I have to work a lot harder with the young boys. Now it's my slogan, so what, who cares?
Yeah, what's funny, this is funny truth. She never actually said that before, but now she says it all the time.
Did I not say that? I actually did say it once.
You know, you say like, who cares?
That, I used to say either, so what?
Yeah.
He put them together.
Yeah.
That's his genius. That's his genius.
That's his brilliance.
We had the most amazing childhood growing up. I mean, we lived in like this really kind of private area in Beverly Hills.
It was a big cul-de-sac that we lived on with only, what, three houses?
Yeah, but we would throw our frisbees over the yard because Bruce Springsteen lived next door.
Condoleezza Rice is actually a co-host today. I don't know why she's doing this. She let herself in for this. Did you do this on purpose? I remember begging you, but I don't remember.
I did it on purpose. I'm going to do it with my friends out there. It'll be a lot of fun.
Well, I wish it could be Christmas every day. When the kids start singing and the band begins to play.
Is the Jennifer Hudson of Dancing with the Stars. You're the Jennifer Hudson of Dancing with the Stars.
Yes.
Only good things will happen to be from
exactly
being
what to say to get a hug.
This is very sweet. You see this fruit? It was supposed to be for Susan Boyle. Susan Boyle was supposed to get the fruit, and Bob said, give me that damn fruit out of her bag.
I actually had a Susan Boyle Lance this morning.
The show obviously is a huge hit, and you're going to do this for, 7, 8, 10 years?
Hopefully, yeah.
That'd be great.
Do you need a cop on your show?
Yeah, Orson, Indiana needs one black person.
Yeah.
It's okay. Always. I'm that good black person that works very well with white people.
Did you just tell me I'm a black woman?
Oh, God.
I had no idea.
We don't do that here, Tyler. We never say, we never use
we never say, oh,
we never tell her she's black.
I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm sorry, but... Yeah.
I accidentally threw away my other shoe.
She did.
I put it by the garbage, and the friggin' garbage man took it. Now I only got one shoe.
Why? How can you accidentally throw away anything that huge?
Because I was trying on different shoes and I put the other shoe by the garbage and I guess they thought it was trash. So now I only got one shoe. Shut up!
Okay, we're talking about their breast examination.
You can't even look at the camera.
So how did it go?
I'm still sore. My boobs hurt because they took.
See, this is why I don't want to. This is exactly what I was afraid of.
They're still searching for mine. They're like, we can't locate.
Chef. Okay.
Okay, Thanksgiving plans. Your hair is lovely, by the way.
Well, thank you.
My father always liked the turkey's ass. He would always insist on the turkey's ass. But since he passed away, I'll have to eat the turkey's ass.
Well, it won't be the first time.
Yeah, I know.
Well, I probably will be eating a turkey sandwich in an editing room because we have an interview with President and Mrs. Obama on Friday night, and I'll be editing it.
Jeffrey and I are taking an airplane. We're flying to L.A. I'm going through a pat down.
Yeah.
I'm so excited.
By the way,
pick my TSA agents.
By the way, your frisking should take like an hour and a half.
Yeah, I'm telling you. I don't even think I'm wearing a bra. I want this to be as easy as possible.
Who is the other person?
Her twin sister.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my gosh. Look at those nails.
I'll be chrome for Christmas.
You know what? They look dangerous. There's something S&M-ish about that, but I don't want to get into that either.
Match my clothes.
Anyway, it's great to have you here. Great to have you here. Whoop, it's great to have you here, too.
I'm glad to be here. I'm glad to be anywhere that's going to pay me.
Check out our daily blog by logging onto our website. We'll be right back with Glee's Jane Lynch. Yay!
Secret Santa?
How? It was my idea.
Well, you're not the only person at this school who consumes protein powder by the tubful. Remember when I told you I was taking all those science textbooks to an exorcist? Well, that's what we call a diversion.
You filled your tub with your name only.
You're a regular Agatha Christie, except even more sexless. See, people, I hate Christmas, but I love presents.
After 100 film and TV credits, Jane Lynch finally won a well-deserved Emmy for playing cheerleading coach and tormentor of the Gleeks, Sue Sylvester, on the mega hit show Glee. Please welcome Jane Lynch. You congratulations on your Emmy for Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Comedy Series.
Thank you.
For your role on Glee, you were so fantastic in this. This show is such a huge phenomenon, Jay. Jane, what do you think, why do you think people feel that way?
I think raising your voice in song is about the most vulnerable and raw form of expression there is, and I think people really react to that. It's really going out on a limb. Yeah. It's allowing your feelings to be naked and out there, and I think especially kids love that, and there's no more tough hierarchy than high school, and we really kind of make that clear that...
But you really hit the nail on the head in terms of just reminding us of that one person in school that was like you, exactly like you, and sort of did torture us throughout our growing years, which I think is really wise of you to do. You do a good job. Congrats, too, because you have an Emmy for... your role is Charlie Sheen's therapist. And I think that that's interesting because...
Thank you. Emmy nomination. Betty White won it.
Emmy nomination,
still.
You're
thank
on
you.
It.
That's pretty great.
Yeah, thank you. But what would the therapist say about Charlie Sheen's situation
now? I think what's so wonderful about what Charlie Sheen is going through, this kind of downfall. They use it in the show. The episode I did, they came right out and they basically took the incidents that happened in real life and they put him on the show. And hopefully it's cathartic for him. And,
sure.
And they're making fun of it.
Right away.
Now, you know, on a Glee, so many folks that we love appear in your show. You had Britney Spears, who came on the show. Gwyneth Paltrow appeared on the show. Now, coming up for the next season, can we expect any more folks on the show?
Gwyneth Paltrow is coming back. So I know about that, and she was so good in the other one. It showed she has the goods, that she can dance, she can sing, she can act, and we worked her butt off that week. She was with us. She did like five numbers, and she wants to come back, so.
That's nice.
Good. Are you about to become a wax figure in Madame Tussauds?
I am a wax figure.
was freaky.
Look at that.
Isn't that the weirdest thing? When you see it standing there?
Yeah, I felt like looking at my own corpse.
Yeah.
It really did.
But it's a good looking corpse.
I look great then. Yeah.
Well, my corpse will wave to your corpse.
Oh, good.
Because I'm in there as well.
You're in there as well.
Great.
You know, and Jane, I gotta say, one of the best clips, one of the best things that you ever did on Glee, your rendition of Madonna in a Vogue clip. Oh. Okay, you remember that? Wait, but for those of you who don't, let's look at this again. Okay. You were so good.
Thank you. I worked my butt off.
That's what I was going to say. How hard was
that? That was hard. It took me like 4 months to get that, and you only have to do it right once.
You're singing, too.
Well, I'm lip syncing.
Oh.
But, it is me singing. Yes, it is my voice.
Okay, now, did Madonna, did you get any word from Madonna?
She released a statement saying that she approved. Yeah. And she liked it a lot. She felt, you know, we definitely did it to pay tribute to her.
It's an homage.
An homage is right, yeah. Ryan Murphy, the guy who created our show, grew up in the 80s, like me, and, you know, he just was in love with her, and this was a very, very important episode for him.
That was fun.
Yes.
You know, looking at some of the past work of yours, Best in Show, Talladega Nights, 40-Year-Old Virgin, Julie and Julia, have you always been funny?
I guess you'd have to, yes, I will answer for people around me.
Well, you know that you're funny. If you're funny, people are laughing.
Exactly, and right. It definitely is, and I'm sure you guys know this, too, that it's a good way to, you know, get in there socially is to make light of things, you know, which is
good. People know what they are. A beautiful woman knows that she's beautiful.
Not always.
Men are throwing themselves at her. Hello.
Not always. I don't think
come
so.
Come on. Well, you have to own it. There's a difference between owning it and not owning it.
I know it's
across
the line, but still.
Yes.
Embracing it.
Yeah.
It's a different thing.
I heard you got married.
I did. I got married in Massachusetts, May 31st of this year. Thank you.
Summer, you and Laura Embry, you guys got married, and two children.
Yes.
You became an instant mother.
A stepmother, 50 years old, and I never had the biological knock-knock, you know, like, let's have a baby. Never had it. Now
never
I have
felt
this.
It.
Never felt it, and I just have given birth to a 9-year-old child. And
how old are both of them?
Nine and a 10-year-old.
And you got your figure back so nicely.
And they're great. It's wonderful, and they're really unique kids, and a lot of fun.
So how does it feel when because you're an instant mother, you know, you're used to sleep. And now you got the kids running through the house, opening up their fridge.
I'm not used to sleeping. I'm up at the crack of dawn, so it's pretty good. I get them to school.
Yeah, the kids are used to sleeping.
Yeah, right.
She's got them up.
Hayden can sleep. She can sleep till noon. She can probably sleep all day if we didn't wake her.
You know, this has been a banner year for gay people in this country, and particularly this week.
Yes.
With the Don't Ask, Don't Tell.
I know. I'm so happy.
It's really great legislation. I think the president did a fantastic job.
I do too. And I criticized him a little bit about
it. I never did because I always feel that he knows what he's doing. And it turns out I was right. He knows exactly what he's doing.
Yeah.
He just does it at his pace, you see?
Yeah, I know. He's definitely a slow. I want things done like that. And, you know, one of the things that I heard on the news yesterday, almost to a man or woman, was that this really isn't going to change anything in the military, except that people don't have to walk around in secret anymore. And that's a
good point. A really good friend of ours said the same thing. He said the soldiers don't care either way as long as they're doing your job. It shouldn't matter. I want to talk about, Sherry mentioned that your kids, but you're doing something pretty powerful for kids out there, which I love. You're working with LG about a text education program.
Right.
Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, it started with, I text while driving. I don't anymore while driving. I used to do these little things like, I can finish this as I'm going. There's no traffic. I used to do all that stuff. And then they approached me, do you want to do this? And I was like, absolutely. And I put my phone in the glove compartment every time I drive now. And it's basically talk to kids about this texting. 45% of kids admit to texting while driving. Mm. So that's just the ones who admit it. And
well, what's the repercussion of doing? What if you get caught doing that? Do you go to jail? Do you get your license suspended? Do they take your
car? It depends on the city. Like we're not allowed in LA.
Six-point system right here.
Is that right?
I think so. You have like so many strikes against you, and then you lose your license.
Until you hit somebody.
I think they're redefining the laws as
then
well.
You lose it.
So what your role is to actually go and talk to the kids?
Well, no, we did these hopefully funny vignettes, talking to parents, almost like a traffic school situation, telling them how to look for signs, and you know, you're not going to stop kids from texting. You just have to teach them to use it responsibly. That's and right. So we have hopefully these funny things at lgtexted.com.
Okay.
Thank you.
Very proud of you.
Jane, thank you for coming by. We congratulate you on every phase and facet of your life. It's a good year for you. Our thanks to Jane Lynch. Everyone in our audience is going home with a Glee Season 1 gift set, which includes Season 1 on DVD and a special Glee Journal. We'll be right back with Emily Osment.
All you have to do is hang on. To the horse.
Oh, all right, okay.
Okay, ready?
All right.
One, two, three.
Am I on?
Open your eyes and find out.
I'm on a horse! I'm on a horse! I'm on a horse.
Center stage with a brand new CD, Fight or Flight. Please welcome Emily Osment.
Congratulations. So, you look fantastic.
Thank you.
You love your band
girl.
Back here.
Yes.
Before we talk music, though, let's talk the show. A few weeks ago on Hannah Montana, Hannah revealed her identity and took the wig off, let everybody know who she really was. So everyone thought the show was done, but it's not. It's going to go on.
I'm pretty sure there's still a few more. Yeah, no, it's...
You meaning like, is this the... We're nearing the end?
We're definitely nearing the end. I love this end segment of the series because you get to see her take on... You get to see Miley take on being famous in both aspects of her life. And it brings a whole different storyline. And the writers had a lot of fun with this part of the series.
So it's fresh.
There's definitely a lot more hour-longs coming up. So,
okay, good.
Yeah, check that out.
Love an hour-long episode.
Yeah,
now, you know, Emily, last week we were talking about Miley because there was a video that surfaced of her smoking a legal substance from a bong. Now, it's been a lot of stuff about Miley. Do you think that the media is just too hard on her? Do you think we should leave her alone? Too much attention?
Well, honestly, I feel like all women in the industry face a lot of scrutiny for a lot of things, and I feel like it's not really fair that much when it comes to just the publicity that you get, the good or the bad. So I feel like in a lot of ways, we should back off everyone. Really.
Do you think, you know, when you have a young audience, right, from the show, do you put pressure on yourself to say, oh my goodness, if I know a 6-year-old, 7-year-old, 10-year-old girl is really looking up to me, do you think about that when you're out? Do you think about how you're gonna order your life?
Honestly, I don't even really have to because I have 6-, 7-, and 8-year-old cousins who I know their mother would kill me if I did anything, you know? So I'm a role model in my own aspect with my own family.
That's
so
good.
I don't have to worry about that.
Yeah. Keeps you in line. I want to talk to you about the CD, Fight or Flight.
Sure.
Certainly not your typical ABC pop here, right? So talk to us about the style of the music and what you think of it.
Sure, yeah. This is my first full-length record. It took me about a year to write and record and produce and finish it. And produced the record with Nellie Hooper, who I've always been a huge fan of. And it was a really wonderful experience. And I'm so happy it's finally out. It's pop, but it's got an edge to it. You're going to find out pretty soon. And it's kind of psychedelic. It's fun.
Well, you know, you've been touring.
Yes.
And so you're about to go out. You're about to go tour some more. So I just got to know, when you're out there on the stage, what are your fans like when you're singing?
There's definitely a large mix of an audience. You have the young, you have the old, you have the brother that totally doesn't want to be there but's there for the little sister, and you have the parents, and you have the uncle, and you know, you have a lot of different people, which I love, and the music is not just for kids, it's for everybody.
We're excited to hear it. Here to perform Lovesick off her CD Fight or Flight, give it up for Emily Osment.
Let's go, 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 give me that. Keep your cavalier with that delicious thing. Well, it takes two to dance four on the floor. All I can eat away. All I can eat away.
All I can eat away.
Boom, boom, supersonic, boom, supersonic, boom. You make my heart go boom, boom. Boom, boom, supersonic, boom, supersonic, boom. You make my heart go supersonic, boom. You got me high. You got me low. You make me think go, go, go out of control. You got me high, you got me low. You make me go, go, go out of control. I love the way we flow. Let's go, go, go. Give me that sensory overload. Got me love, got me love, got me love. Sick. Got me love, got me love. You got me love. Sick. Turn it up, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up. Turn it up, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up. Boom, boom, supersonic, boom, supersonic, boom. You make my heart go boom.
You make my heart go
boom, boom, supersonic, boom, supersonic, boom.
Supersonic boom.
Thank you.
You know what? I'm loving that. I like it. It's fresh.
Thank you.
Our thanks to Emily Osment. Hey, members of the studio audience are going home with a copy of her CD. We'll be right back.
Collection on DVD has all of Bogey's greatest on-screen moments, and members of our audience are going home with a copy.
Another gift.
Enjoy. What are you doing? What's up with you?
Well, tonight on my show on HLN, which is at 9 o'clock on HLN, we're going to have Senator Kristen Gillibrand on. She is the person, she's a senator from New York, who basically got this 9/11 first responders bill for the firefighters.
And we can.
She's
tonight.
On my show tonight.
What time?
9 o'clock on HLN.
And you know what else? Listen, our show tomorrow is a real new show. And if you want to write to us and tell us how you felt about whatever we said, you're not going to hear us respond tomorrow because it's a tape show. But we'll be back. Have a great day. Take a little time to enjoy the view.